believe it.
Is he still real? Is he there?
You're alone in these mountains.
Is that Delia?
Nothing lives here.
You won't
survive.
You met him by the tree.
She met him by the tree.
Maybe it's a sign, the tree.
What's he trying to tell you?
He's waiting for you by the tree.
Sigmund's sister trades shapes with a sorceress, and in disguise, she lies with her own brother. She gives birth to a son named Sinfjotli. After a time, she sends him to the forest to Sigmund. He tests the boy and finds him strong and fearless, and so they go to take their vengeance on King Siggeir. As Sigmund and Sinfjotli are being buried alive, Sigmund's sister throws an armful of straw into the grave mound. Hidden in the straw is Sigmund's sword, the gift of Odin. They cut their way out of the grave mound and set fire to Siggeir's hall. The king burns to death. Sigmund calls to his sister to come out so that she may live and be honored. She does. Of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older, and where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
What is this place? It feels wrong.
It feels strange.
Where is it? Where are we?
Turn back.
This is wrong. This has to be wrong.
There he is.
Didius.
The light.
Go towards it.
He's in the house.
He's going in. He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
The air.
Where's it gone? Keep going.
How do you find it?
It's just a trial. Just another test.
Test. Like the old warrior trials. Cillian will help me.
You can almost see him.
The stench of rot. She can almost taste it. Do you smell it? No. Don't worry. Not everyone can. Spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. But the water. She could taste the rot. But no one else could. She knew something was wrong. Something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing. And they knew that she was not like them.
The Northmen speak of a death moon, a light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the death moon appear at a farm, and first the shepherd died, then a guest died, and then the farmhands, and then the farmer and six of his men drowned at sea. But that is not the end of it, because the dead return to haunt the living. If you see the death, because there will be death in that house.
A line to the truth. The bridge.
She did it.
She did it.
Fixed the bridge.
She fixed it.
You passed the trial. Get to the house.
You succeeded.
To me. Where are you?
I'm here. I'm right here.
Are you in there? Come out if you are.
Where is he? Find him.
You have to find him.
The runes.
Focus.
Focus on the runes.
There was a Northman called Grettir. Big, red-haired, immensely strong. But he was afraid of the dark. It happened one night.
Dillian! They're coming for me!
It's Dillian. Go to him.
Dillian,
go to him. He's trying to save you.
see. Don't get me lost.
Don't let it see you.
You're stopped.
Nothing. There it is. Move away.
Don't get it.
Quick.
What shall I do?
Where is he?
This is taking too long. Can you hear him?
You're
two
lost.
Two more rooms.
You have to find them
somewhere. Where are you? You're lost.
Where are they?
This all looks the same. It's close. It's close. Move away. Senua, move away.
I feel it.
You'll die. You're dying. The burning
She's
has begun.
Dying. The burning.
The burning has begun.
Go to the gate.
There they are.
The rooms. You can get through.
Senua! What happened?
They're blaming me for the plague. They said Say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void. That doesn't make them true.
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I am. You're not a monster.
Without you, this darkness has made me a monster.
You did it.
But there's more. There's more.
You're tired, but you have to keep going.
There's still more.
There's always more to do.
It's not going to be easy.
You're getting tired. Can you do another one? It's too much.
Have you got the energy?
She hasn't got the energy.
No.
Too much to do.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur, the second son of Odin. He was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
Is broken.
There's no way you can fix it.
What do you do now, son?
Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness.
Thank you. Dillian.
There he is. What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through.
Where is he?
Where's he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the
world. He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark world.
The dark.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senna explored new paths into the unknown.
You can't.
And she keeps fighting.
We spend our lives searching for the meaning in life, and we ask the gods for guidance. But the truth to life is revealed when we can face death without fear. How can the gods understand us if they refuse to die themselves?
Gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear. Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Huth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Huth says, "I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon." Loki replies, Northmen tell how the gods mourned Baldur. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her reins. She pushes Baldur's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Baldur's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief, and she dies. She's put next to her husband, and the pyre is lit, sending the dead to hell. But even so, the gods cannot accept his death.
He was the only one. You are guilty. Was it worth it? Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movements. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. He was the only one that of Zinbel and her past, and Dillian, her future. Two realities tearing at her soul. Do you remember the way he stroked your hair? Nobody will know. Do you remember what it feels like? Is pointless.
What are you doing? Why did you think you could...
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they?